Welcome to a special London edition of Sporty News. Today, Tunyis Tonge gets stuck. Oscar Pistorius is in the starting blocks. Laura Flessel has fun. Usain Bolt is crazy about football. And Obama, basketball and the kiss cam. Are we sure they'll ever actually get there? It's all very well going on about London 24/7, but will everyone make it to the competition on D-Day? We wouldn't blame Tunyis Tonge for having his doubts. The French canoeist had a little trouble getting to practice and ended up missing it altogether. Unfortunately for Tony, he got stuck with a bus driver that got lost in London. If he'd had his canoe handy, Tony could have taken a shortcut along the Thames, may have been faster. But seriously, it gets worse. Karen Clément, the two-time 400-meter hurdles world champion, was trapped in his bus for 4 whole hours. The angry track and field star tweeted, "Athletes are sleepy, hungry, and need to pee. Could we get to the Olympic Village, please?" Maybe he would have been better off walking to practice. While on the upside, at least all this happened sooner rather than later, like on competition day, for example. And there's still time for organizers to invest in a sat-nav. There's a lot of talk of Bolt, the Jamaican, but Oscar, the South African, could be the surprise star. Oscar Pistorius is set to light up the track in London. No matter what the outcome, he's already won his bet by becoming the first amputee athlete to compete in the Olympic Games. He'll be running in the 4x400-meter relay and, more impressively, the individual 400-meters event.
It's just a dream come true and a massive blessing. It's been 6 years of a lot of hard work and sacrifice from my end, and not only from me, but from my team.
In his interview with Laureus, for whom he is an ambassador, he still seemed in shock.
I'm going to find out at midday, and at about 11 o'clock, I couldn't take it anymore. And I said to my coach, "Come, let's go to the gym, go blow off some steam and put on some music and just get out of this environment. I can't wait any longer."
His coach's wife is the one who went to the gym to break the good news, and Oscar is still on cloud nine, somewhere between relief and surprise.
It was just overwhelming. It was, I think it took a couple of days for it to settle in, and it's really, I don't think it'll fully settle in until I'm on the starting blocks.
Looks like champions only want to have fun. What have they been up to before heading to London? They've been letting their hair down. Need proof? Laura Flessel couldn't leave without confronting Captain Hook in Disneyland Paris and spending some time with the Pirates of the Caribbean. No big surprises there. Pirates, Laura, swords, the Caribbean, it all makes sense. It's just what she needed ahead of her final training seminar in the Alps. Just as brave, the ladies from the French national football team chose to visit Disneyland on Friday the 13th. They certainly aren't superstitious. They tested out the Tower of Terror, the rock and roller coaster, before paying a visit to Sleeping Beauty's castle for a souvenir snap. Talk about cliché. What if Usain Bolt's records on the 100 and 200 meters were nothing more than an accident? When the sprint champion chats about golf or football, it sounds as though Lightning Bolt could have made a mint in an entirely different sport. And he certainly knows his classics.
Zinedine Zidane, great, one of the greatest ever.
What's the word for it? Embarrassment? Rejection? And during a US-Brazil game, too. That's what happened to Barack Obama, who was caught out by the kiss cam during a Team USA basketball game in the run-up to the Olympic Games. Barack was trapped by the kiss cam, but his wife Michelle refused to give him a peck the first time around. The kiss cam is this camera that zooms in on couples during NBA games, forcing its victims to kiss each other for all to enjoy on a giant screen. When the kiss cam chooses you, there's nowhere to hide, and you can't back out because the audience loves a good show. The first lady had to give in eventually, the second time around. At least the president managed to save some face.